Hey guys, so today is December 22, 2013, and so now I like to just talk about the entire set of the Davids Tea Festive Collection. This is the Christmas set available for this year in 2013, like one of their sets. If you go onto the website, they have several different collections that is available in Christmas time, like a lot of the three-pack collections, but this is a festive collection, so it's available throughout the Christmas season until it sells out, and they also sell each of the flavors that I'm going to tell you about loosely. You can buy them by the pack separately until they sell out in the website or in the store. So you can check it out if you like it, if you're interested. So let's go through all the teas that they have in this 9 teas. I've done 5 tea videos already, but because I'm a little bit short of time, so because of work and stuff, so sorry about that. So I just rather do one big tea review video, and I won't be brewing any more tea because I've already had like 3 or 4 cups of tea already today already. So they've got 9 teas in the set. 4 of the teas have caffeine, and 5 of the teas are actually herbal blends. So if you are looking for more caffeine teas, this tea might not be for you. The set might be not be for you. So the first tea is the Santa Secret. And once again, I've tried all of the teas already, but it's just to find the time to make the video was the problem. This one is the Santa Secret. So what it is basically, this is actually surprisingly, it's a very good one. Santa Secret. And so what the ingredients are, is that it's got a Chinese black tea, peppermint, leaves, candy cane sprinkles, mono, they're all the ingredients for the candy cane sprinkles listed, and natural and artificial flavoring, and they tell you that it contains soy. So this one is just basically, it's a spiked up peppermint tea, because usually the peppermint tea is really boring, but they mix in the black tea, so you get your caffeine dose. Regular peppermint tea does not have caffeine, but black tea you add it, so you can have it in the morning and stuff if you really need your caffeine boost. And so the candy cane, it just adds a little bit of festive in it, but doesn't really make much difference to it. And I do not add any teas. I do not add any sugars or creams into my teas at all, but the candy cane sprinkles does make it a little bit more sweet, so keep in mind if you're watching about the sugar. So I really do enjoy this one, and so before the Christmas holiday ends, I'm just thinking about which teas I like to buy again. And so the Santa Secret is certainly one of them. And I forgot to mention, I tweeted David's Tea about it. So I'm going to tweet David's Tea after I upload this video that I've told them already. On their packaging for this year, they made a mistake on their tins with the white chocolate frost tea. So this is the white chocolate frost tea. White chocolate frost tea. And they label their information on the back of each tin about the brewing times and information. They labeled it wrong. They labeled this is the Santa Secret one, as you can see. They also labeled it white chocolate frost. So David's Tea, I'm just pointing you out to that. I tweeted you about that. Sorry for late time making this video. You guys printed out 2 times white chocolate frost. 2 times. And they are the different teas here. So I'll tweet you back when I make this video, David's Tea. And David's Tea is really good. They tweet you guys back. They tweet everybody back. So the next tea is one of the most fun teas. This one is Glitter and Gold. I made a video about that, so you look on my tea blog playlist, okay? So glitter and gold, I recommend. And Alpine Punch. This is a yum tea. It tastes like almond tofu. More description on my tea blog. I made a video about that already. I recommend. And this one is the gingerbread tea. You can see I only had one or two of this. And this one is a rooibos tea blend. And let me read you out the ingredients. This one is rooibos, green rooibos, honeybush, cinnamon, cassia, currants, ginger, pineapple, safflower petals, natural and artificial gingerbread, and molasses flavoring. When I opened the tin of the gingerbread, when I open the tin of the gingerbread, it does smell some aroma of like baking cookies or something. But then, like I said before in the Alpine Punch video, I don't like the earthy taste that comes from the rooibos tea. And when I do brew this tea, it smells the same like the loose, the dry tea leaf, but it doesn't really hit the mark of the gingerbread, so I can still taste the earthy tea for it, so I won't be rushing back to buy this particular gingerbread tea. But if you like rooibos tea, you may like this tea, so don't count me on it. You can try it if you like. I'm not a fan of it, but you might like it, so I'm not bashing down on David's tea or anything, but I'm just doing a review of everything. So the next one, it's a one that I'm surprisingly like. It's the white chocolate frost. Cause I'm not a fan of peppermint teas much, but I know peppermint tea is good for the stomach. So every time I eat a lot, I go to peppermint tea for help. That's about it. But this one, it takes peppermint tea up to the top notch, to the next level. I'll read you out the ingredients for white chocolate frost. Peppermint, white chocolate, milk powder, cocoa butter, soy lecithin, pink peppercorn, stevia leaf, natural sugar flavoring, artificial white flavor, white chocolate mousse flavoring. It contains milk and soy. So this one, this is what it looks like, and you can see the little bits of the peppercorn and the chocolate bits in it. At first, when I first tried it, I thought it was kind of meh, it's just like a peppermint tea. But I brew it close to the 10 minute mark. You need to brew it longer for the flavors to get together, brew together better. And then you can taste the spiciness as you drink it down, it hits the throat. So if you do not like spicy teas, if you are sensitive to spicy food, you might want to pass this along, because if you know you do not handle spicy stuff well, you don't want to try this one. So this one I take into liking of this tea. I do enjoy this white chocolate frost because it makes the boring peppermint tea more exciting, and the flavor actually lingers around in your mouth actually long time. So I do really recommend this white chocolate frost to you. But if you are gluten free or allergic to gluten, I don't recommend that, of course. And so I just uploaded the sleigh ride tea video today. Very good. You just look up the tea block, okay? And then this one is Choconut Oolong. You can see it's very, very low now. I've had quite a bit of it since the last time I made the video. It's good, I like that. And so I like to make an update on the spiced fig tea. You can see I really haven't had much of it since I made the video, but I like to correct myself when I said it in the other video that I didn't like it as much. But it is a herbal tea blend, and herbal tea blends tend to take a longer time to make the flavors come out more. So I tried it the second time a few days later after that video I made. I brewed it for close to 10 minutes. Then the flavors are starting to pop out, and this one really is a festive tasting one. So it's got no caffeine in it. It says 6 to 8 minutes, but I say you brew it close to 10 minutes, then you will get the magic out from this tea. So it's good, but it's not wow, it's not great. And so the last tea here is the coffee cake. This one is just a boring, not exciting, it's just like a black tea. So let me read you in the ingredients for the black tea. The coffee cake tea, I mean. It got black tea, cherries, pineapple, natural and artificial cake flavoring. It contains sulfites. This one basically is just a spiked up vanilla flavor black tea. That's all it is, guys. So if in any of the stores near your area or whatnot sells a vanilla flavored black tea, you can try that. But David's Tea do got a line of cake flavored tea, and I do like the red velvet cake one, and that is a regular product that they carry. So if you want to try a cake tea, you can try the red velvet cake tea. And my cousin got misled when I told her about the coffee cake tea, and she says, oh, does it have coffee flavor in it? No, it's just the style and the name of the cake. It's got nothing to do with coffee, so don't get fooled by that, guys. It's just the style of the cake and the name of the cake. Apparently my cousin, she never had coffee cake before, so took a while to explain to her. So I'm now gonna go through what I would go back to the store to buy first. And once again, out of this set, the glitter and gold, you do not have to rush to go to buy it, because it's a regular carry product. They carry this product all year round, the glitter and gold, okay? So don't be worried about that. And so I'll take my top picks for you. My top pick is, surprisingly, Alpine Punch. That one tastes like almond tofu. I love that one. I'm worried that I might not get enough out of this tea, so that's Alpine Punch. The next one would be, runner-up would be Choconut Oolong. It tastes like a cup of hot chocolate, so I will be definitely getting stock up more on that. And in the third place runner-up I might stock up on is this white chocolate frost. Because like once every few days, if I crave for peppermint tea, I can go to this one. So these are the three runner-up teas out of the 9 that I may want to go back for out of the 9. So, you know, these kits are really great. Like if you are new to loose leaf teas, or if you want to get your friend into tea, you can buy the one set. And this set is $49.50 Canadian, so it works out to be five something for each tin of tea. So you can try it all. If you don't like it, it's okay. It's okay. You don't waste a whole bag of it. So if you like none of it, alright, you can try other types of tea. But out of the 9, I like 3, so David's Tea got the winner there. I'm gonna go back and buy 3 types of tea. So until next time, guys, this might be a longer video because I'm talking about all types of 9 teas, so I'll probably list all the types of tea in the information box below. This is from the Davids Tea Festive Collection 2013. So I hope you guys like this video. Any questions, you can actually, because of this Google Plus thing, just send me a private message if you have any comments. I reply to those faster. So yeah, so the Davids Tea Festive Collection 2013 set. So I might finish the individual tea reviews later on, but I want to bring out the information to you before Christmas holidays done. So, yeah, until next time, I wish you guys a Merry Christmas. I hope you guys enjoy your teas, whatever teas you guys like to drink. And cheers, and have a Merry Christmas.